Hey guys, how's it going? Fried Applesauce here, and today we are going to be doing another album review. I'm going to be doing quite a few of these. This actually isn't a Muse one, as you can tell by the title and the thumbnail. This is by my second favorite band of all time. Muse just passed them, but it's my favorite album of all time. This is the album that got me into MCR, and this is, in my opinion, one of the best rock albums of all time. This is the Black Parade, and it's another concept album. You don't know what that is. Basically, album that tells a story, musical without the acting. That's how I always have been describing it these last few videos. You start off with the end, which sets you up. The main character is called the Patient, and he's dying on this deathbed. And you can hear it because the first sounds from the album before, and it's actually a calm song as far as MCR goes, but right before Gerard Way's vocals come in, you just hear beeping from the hospital machine is what it's supposed to be. So that is that. And obviously the song is much longer. It's 153. But it is an amazing setup. I love how it just boosts you into this world immediately. And this album, I listen to it at the bare minimum once a month, which doesn't seem like much, but, you know, listen to so much music that me listening to one album all the way through is sort of rare. I'll listen to like half an album and switch or something like that. None of the songs on the Black Parade are skippable for me, because most songs you have, or most albums, you have at least one song. Like Drones, I give that a really good review, but Aftermath, I just sort of skipped that one. I didn't really like that one as much. Same with Dead Inside. But I can't skip any on the Black Parade. Don't know why. It's just the music's that good. But listen to this transition. And at first I wondered, okay, why does the end, why does this audio cut out at the end? It's because it goes straight into Dead. Straight into Dead, where obviously, you know, the dude's dead now. I'm just going to have you hear this transition. It is amazing. It is amazing. So yeah, that is the transition. In case you didn't catch it, I'm just going to play the first part of Dead. And the end, I feel like, can stand on its own. Dead can't quite, and sounds sort of weird just coming in like this, for me, especially, because I never just listened to one of them, but yeah, this is how this sounds. And basically, he is dead in this, obviously, as you can tell by the title, and it's another song of them, this one not obviously slow at all, as you could hear from that initial, whatever you'd call that, just the yell, I guess. It's a lot of these songs have so many different sounds, and I don't know, man. I don't know how to explain them. It's just really clean how they all sort of play off each other. Really like it. That leads us into The Sharpest Lives, and most of the time, like I said, I listen to like half an album, because half an album's really strong, and then it just sort of falls off. This is the best opening part of an album. I consider the opening to Welcome to the Black Parade is when the opening sort of changes into the middle. The ending's really strong, but this is the best opening section to an album I've ever heard. I love this. And The Sharpest Lives, for me, a lot of these songs, the end and Dead together, This Is How I Disappear, Sharpest Lives, Mama, House of Wolves, Sleep. For me, all of this just brings back a lot of memories. I only listened to it 2 years ago, but it is insane how fast that time can fly. And the beginning of The Sharpest Lives is amazing. And for me, whenever I hear that, it sets me up and I know, okay, I know what's coming next. It's the high point of the album. We'll get to that. We'll get to that. This is sort of from the perspective of a drunk person, I guess.
ends and it pours when you're out on your own. If I crash on the couch, can I sleep in my clothes?
So there you go. If it, well, it rains and it pours when you're out on, it rains and it pours when you're out all alone. If I crash on the couch, can I sleep in my clothes? I don't want to play too much of these songs for you. I want you guys to listen for yourselves because it's truly a work of art. But it is amazing. And then you get to the song that defined a generation. This is how I accidentally discovered My Chemical Romance. I was in the back of my dad's car driving to get Chinese. It's a really weird story, but it just sort of changed my life, honestly. I know it sounds cringy, but sort of did. Because this really got me into music. But this song came on the radio. I came home, I listened to it. And then a few years later, I heard Na Na Na. 1 year later, I guess. And I realized, oh wait, that's by the same people. Started listening to this. And yeah, so the iconic G note, this is really what started a generation. 2006 to really 2008, so not too long, but this song is definitely their staple. If you know MCR, if you know at least one song, chances are it's this. I don't want to play too much of the song again. This really is a work of art, so I'm just going to show you how much it can change just in segments. Because in segments, it sounds really weird how much it changes. If you listen to the whole song, it flows so smoothly, you barely even realize it. I'm going to show you the first opening lines and just skip through a few different parts of the song till you get to the end. It's a whole nother song then.
When I was a young boy, my father took me into the city to see a marching band.
So you have that iconic first line, and then you skip a little bit. I'm going to skip to 144 here. And then you go to, I'm going to go to 3 minutes here. I mean, the song just changes so much. I'm going to go to 411 here now. Here's 439. Just changes so much. I only played a few segments there. It's amazing. I love the song. Love the album. That's obviously like their most iconic song. Then we move into I Don't Love You. Another song. That's amazing. Welcome to the Black Parade. I Don't Love You and Teenagers. And Famous Last Words. And Cancer. Those are all most of the songs that initially got me interested in MCR. Love them. And then you get to this amazing riff of on House of Wolves. It is, I love it. It's one of my favorite guitar riffs. And I mean, it's just the whole album, really. I'm going to keep saying this. It's amazing. So, sounds sort of simple. If you listen to it more and more and more, still amazing. Then you have a song, you know, it's been a sort of heavy rock album this whole time, minus I Don't Love You. Boom, you just get nailed in the heart with Cancer. Okay, that sounded phrased wrong. I mean, the next song is called Cancer, and it massively just pulls at your heartstrings. Really sad, though. Really awesome. Really helps move the story along into what I consider sort of the ending phase, which starts at Mama. And he says, this is where it sort of takes a dark turn. We learn more about him. He was sort of a soldier and stuff. You know the song's going to be pretty dark and take the album in a darker direction when the opening line is, Mama, we all go to hell. I love the song, and then we go to sleep. This one took forever to grow on me. Not much to say about. I don't want to say too much, stretch the video too long. You guys should really listen to this yourselves. Honestly, believe that. It's amazing. Teenagers. This one helped get me into MCR. I think I mentioned that. Disenchanted. This is another one that starts off pretty soft. And then by the end, it's erupted to a massive rock song. And then they bring it back down out of nowhere. Works really well. We get to technically the last song. And it is Famous Last Words. And that's a fitting end, you know, the last words for the album. And it is pretty motivational, I guess you would say. I don't know how else to describe it. And the patient's struggling with something. He ends up being better, struggling with death, and now he started to grasp it, and he's like, okay. And he says, I'm not afraid to keep on living. I'm not afraid to walk this world alone. That is one of the best MCR lyrics, in my opinion. I love it. Then we get the blood, which is a minute and a half of silence. And then it's just... This would be... If the Black Parade was a movie, which I really think it could be, like a musical, and it'd be awesome. The screen goes black. And this would sort of be like your Marvel Avengers post-credit scene. His blood, just a fun little thing. I really love this album. I've said that so much, but I've said it a lot as well. Really my favorite album of all time. It's 51 minutes, 53 seconds. So if you have that amount of time, like 52 minutes, and then another 5 hours to just take in what you listen to, definitely I would recommend this. I'd recommend it if you don't have 51 minutes. Just at some point, you have to listen to this. If you're a rock fan, you have to listen to the song, the whole album, really. And this one scores the highest for me from the three album reviews we've done so far. Thank you guys so much for watching this video. I hope you enjoyed it. If you're still watching this far, then thank you especially. Make sure to like the video, comment any other albums you'd like me to do. This is my third one now. And I will see you guys next video.